Hello, in this online tutorial, we will introduce the theory of IPG road and how can we generate roads with different methods, specifically going into more details with the scenario editor. A virtual road consists of one or several links. Different links can be connected to each other by the junctions. Each link has a start node and an end node. It can consist of multiple segments, like a straight segment or a turn segment. One link can also have several line sections with different line tubes and line settings. The 3D profile, like slope, elevation, and camber of the road, can also be defined on the road surface. Other elements, like traffic vehicle, people, and other traffic objects, can also be placed inside the scenario and detected by the sensor to influence the driver's behavior. A driving trajectory can be defined by a route. You can continually select the road path from different line sections or links to create your own route. For a line change scenario, a user-defined path can also be added and merged into a route. Now, we will go into the scenario editor and try some operations. The scenario editor can be reached from main GUI, click Parameters, Scenario and Road, or press Ctrl plus R on your keyboard. This is a shortcut. Pay attention to this icon. This is a switch between the static and dynamic scenario. The dynamic scenario is basically manual settings. In this online tutorial, we will focus on the static scenario that is called Scenario Editor. By clicking this icon, we can load a road from the road file. Here we have the access to the road files that's saved in our project folder under data road, or in our product examples and data road. In our product examples, we can find one road file and a scenario that is called Urban Road Construction and Tunnel. We open it in the scenario editor. We can find there are many different traffic objects and road types here, like the vehicles, also the building and the house, and other 3D objects like the trees, traffic signs. By clicking this 3D preview tool on the top menu, IPG MUI or MUI-NX will be opened in a road preview mode. We can always use our mouse wheel to zoom out or zoom in, or rotate the views. Here, if we click the green triangle, we will find the yellow slider is moving along with the predefined route. The route is predefined and saved with the road file. We can also change the play speed here. Or drag this progress bar. By right clicking, we can find different preview modes, technical drawing, or wireframe mode. More details about this feature will be found in our user's guide, Scenario Editor chapter. Now, I'm going to introduce some methods of building and importing the road files. First, by clicking this road segment icon, we can build a road network in the scenario editor. This approach doesn't require any real data or coordinates, also allows us to build a very complex and detailed road network with different road types. Regarding the 3D profile, gradient and slopes must be defined independently. There is another option, is to left click and press this icon. Then we can see not only the RD5 format root file is supported in CarMaker, but also the root files from third-party tools. For example, an KML file can be obtained from Google Map directly, and SODR file can be obtained from the OpenDrive. Pay attention to this option. If you want to use HD Leaf Map, an additional add-on license will be required. Please read our user's guide for more details. If we left click and press the root segment icon, we can find this option, File. By importing files, we can find all the external format root files saved in our product examples and the project folders. We also have different options of exporting the root files. For this draft, we can export it and save it in the RD5 root format. Also, we can export and save it in an XODR root format with different versions. Before I start to build the root network in the scenario editor, I would like to introduce some useful tools and features. Let's begin with the top menu bar. First, new root definition. It will clear the existing root network and create an empty one. Root network information. It shows basic information on the current root network, like how many junctions, links, objects, or rules are defined here. Line configurations. CarMaker users can create, save, and import line configurations. A line configuration allows us to set the lines, route markings, traffic barriers, and other line attributes. For example, after importing a highway line configuration, we can easily build a highway scenario in the scenario editor. 3D preview. This is a useful tool that allows us to check current road network in our visualization tools. IPGMUI or MoonNX will be opened in a preview mode. Static scenario settings. The parameters here configure general settings for the scenario editor. Pay attention, all the settings or parameters here cannot be changed after the root data was imported or created. View settings. It can hide or show different root elements. To avoid an overloaded preview when a very complex root network is imported. User preference. This dialog is used to define the default parameters and preference for the entire project folder. For example, we can switch between MoonNX and IPGMUI for the 3D preview. MoonNX has a better visualization effect, but it also requires a higher computation power of your PC. I would like to use MoonNX in this online tutorial. Now, let's move to the set menu bar. There are a few panels on the set menu bar. The first one, Tools panel, Selection mode. After selection mode is activated, we click any point on the road network. We can find all the available objects nearby will be shown, and the selected object will be highlighted. We can also mirror the distance from point A to point B, or change the background of the scenario editor. Road editing panel. The editing tools here provide all functionalities to build road networks. For example, we can find different road segment types and junction types. We can also add 3D surface and bumps on the road surface. Accessories panel. Within the accessories panel, features like road markings, traffic signs, traffic light, or barriers will be added, and these accessories are detectable to the sensors. Sensory panel. The features here can beautify the simulation environment by adding the geometry object, tree strips, or generating a terrain. However, all the features here cannot be recognized by IPG driver, neither be detected by the sensors. Traffic panel. By defining route and markers in the traffic panel, ego vehicle or traffic objects can be affected in the simulation. All the tools and features I explained here are well explained in our user's guide. Please go there for more details.